Welcome to Power Electronics lecture series. In this session, I'll be going to explain induction heating, which is so popular in so many applications of power electronics, such as steel hardening, soldering, and brazing. So, how induction heating has been getting done, what are the basics behind, and what is the working principle which is there with induction heating, that will be the case which I'll be going to discuss in this session. So when we talk about induction heating, it is basically working based on electromagnetic induction. So it works based on electromagnetic induction. And high frequency is being utilized to get RF heating. So high frequency is used to get RF heating. Induction is generating eddy current, and that is what we are utilizing for heating. So because of induction, due to induction, eddy current is generated, and eddy current is being utilized for heating. The material to be heated is known as workpiece. The material which is what we want to heat here by using induction heating, that is called as workpiece. So the material to be heated is known as workpiece. The coil wound around material is known as work coil. So basically, induction heating, that is functioning based on electromagnetic induction, and even we use high frequency in induction heating sometimes, so that is even referred as RF heating. Due to induction, it generates magnetizing current as well as eddy current, and that is what utilized for heating. The material which we are heating by using induction heating is called as workpiece, and to heat that material we wound coil around it, that is referred as work coil. So these are the basics that we need to understand. Now let us move on to setup of induction heating. So as earlier I have told, here we use AC signal, that is been connected to coil, and that is wounded around workpiece. So this coil is work coil, and this metal piece which is there with this red color, that is work piece. So by giving this AC signal, there will be a magnetization by this coil, and because of that magnetization there will be a flow of eddy current in this workpiece, and that will be generating heating. So that is what the basic phenomenon. And if we see equivalent circuit, then equivalent circuit, that is this, where this is AC signal, it could be RF signal, it could be low frequency AC signal, that is connected to this coil, that is this. And on the other part, this coil is isolated with respect to this, that's why this is what isolation. And here this is workpiece. So this coil and metal is isolated to each other, and this workpiece, that is getting heated. So this is what its equivalent circuit. Now how induction flows. So to understand that, here I am showing this cross section where this is workpiece, this is work coil, and this is top view of that circuit. Now this is AC supply. Now what happens is, when current is flowing in this direction from this coil, there will be a generation of eddy current inside of this work coil, work piece. So this is how there will be a generation of eddy current. So inside there will be a generation of eddy current like this. And when negative half is there, at the time eddy current will be in this direction. So continuously there will be a generation of eddy current because of induction. So because of electromagnetic induction, there will be a generation of eddy current in workpiece, and that eddy current is utilized for heating. So that is how this basic circuit of induction heating is functioning. Let us move on to some other parts even, so which will gives you clear cut idea about how induction heating is happening. So sometimes when we talk about, when we give high frequency signal, so at that time skin effect is happening. So in RF signal, skin effect happens. So what is skin effect? So when we give high frequency signal, there will be a generation of current in metal. But when frequency is high, at that time current is moving towards skin. So current density is higher at skin side and lower at center. So ultimately, higher the frequency, higher the current density towards perimeter. So I'm just trying to show what happens here. So as we, first of all, if I say there is a DC signal, then current density is uniform, but once we increase frequency, current density is high on the surface. So current density is high on the surface, and as you go inside the metal, then current density decreases. So one can clearly see this by yellow color, I have shown current density. So current density is high and inside it is low. So if I show it by graph, it will be more clear. So exponentially that current density will decrease. So current density with respect to distance. So if I say here, this is what the point, and in this direction I am taking a distance x from this point reference. This is surface, which is what reference point, and with respect to surface towards center, I am considering distance. So let us say that distance is x. So on the surface, density is maximum, and as you go inside, density decreases exponentially. One can see clearly over here, as I move inside, density is decreasing. If I say over here density is rho, then over here density is decreasing. Let us say this is 0.37 rho, and that is how that density is decreasing. And at a density 0.37, distance with respect to surface is called as skin depth. So this is skin depth. So in RF signal, when we do induction heating, at that time what happens is current is flowing on the perimeter of metal, and current density is not uniform throughout a cross section. On the surface, current density is maximum, and as you go inward to the metal, current density decreases. So almost one can say current is high on the surface and less in the center. And this is what I am showing it by this graph, where one can clearly understand on the surface current density is maximum, and as you go inside up to center, current density is decreasing very fast. Exponentially it is decreasing. So this phenomenon even we can utilize for some applications where this current density that could be given for heating. Now let us try to understand how block diagram is there. So as I have explained earlier, high frequency AC source could be utilized, and work coil that is been connected with this, and workpiece that is to be heated by this work coil, and both are isolated, right? So it is not directly connected. Here isolation is there, and this is directly connected. Now here reset timer that we are giving to turn off and turn on. Like for example, if I say this is what the timer I have set, then for this time period induction heating will happen, and that is what connected to application. And for off time period there will be a cooling operation. So for off time period there will be cooling operation, and for on time period there will be heating operation. And this is not necessary feedback path, but in some applications, to get automated application, we need to have feedback path. For example, if I have such application in which we need to maintain a temperature, then if I say I have maintained temperature at 700 degree Celsius, so to maintain temperature at 700 degree Celsius, once I detect that, I'll be giving that to reset timer. So reset timer will be managing this on and off period to maintain temperature by 700 degree Celsius. But in open loop system, this path is not connected. Manually we are operating this. Manually we will be setting what will be reset time, and based on that induction heating is been utilized. So let us sum up this session by few applications. So as I have told earlier, we can use this induction heating for steel hardening. So steel hardening is one very important application which is there with induction heating. Second application is soldering. So at the tip of iron rod, we focus that current to have heating, and that heated current is melting a metal, which is what we are where we provide contact, and that melted one is utilized to get soldering, and that is what we are using it in our electronics laboratory even so many times. So where even we are using same phenomenon, which is induction heating, and in brazing even we utilize induction heating. So these are the various applications. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any query regarding this, you can place comments. Definitely I will reply. And if you have suggestions regarding few videos which is required to complete power electronics, place your suggestions. If I have understanding and knowledge regarding those topics, definitely I will try to make out videos based on that. Thank you so much for watching this video.